If you are hoping to vent your frustrations on our eater friend here, I can only apologize.
Few as they are now, it took us no time at all to track it down.
That suits our purpose perfectly. Now we need only wait for Ardbert to arrive.
Weren't you two meant to be attending to the empty?
We were, and are. But we can hardly ignore the rest of the world. So we thought we might see how things were coming along. From what we can gather, the answer is strangely.
Right now, we think we can do more good here.
It is heartening to have all present.
Indeed. We will be glad of the additional hands should matters escalate.
Our quarry has come.
It seems I've lost this particular race. Well, though I suppose it's only fair. When we first met, it was I who outpaced you. Ravana, was it? But where are my manners? I wouldn't be here were it not for you, and I have yet to say a word of thanks. Poor fellow. He will be sorely missed.
Very well. Let us forego this pretense. After all, it was never you that I needed to deceive. Yes, it is I, Elizabeth. Through your time in Emmet Selk's imitation of our home, I dare say you have gained a better understanding of my role since last we met. Not that it matters.
We understand your role, Emissary, but not your goal. What is it that you seek to achieve?
I seek to enact the will of the Convocation, of course. If it helps you to think of me as but another Ascian, no different in nature or purpose from the rest, you are welcome to do so.
Once, I would have said your goal was destruction alone. Now I understand that you fight for something you love, just as we do. Yet though we seem doomed to clash, I bid you consider Emmet Selk's final words. Remember that we once lived, he said. Had he not seen some glimmer of hope in our kind, I do not believe he would have spoken thus.
None better understood your plight than he. His words must surely be worthy of your consideration.
Emmet Selk. How very unlike you to err so gravely. That one should stray at the end of so onerous a path is understandable, but I had thought you above such weakness. Mayhap you thought the same. Would that I had been present to offer correction. But I shall do so now, as is my duty, and return all to its proper course. As for you, look at yourselves. Look at your history. Look back 100 short years to how your greatest warriors were undone. And now, at but a word from me, you raise your hands in answer like the puppets you are. Naught has changed. You fail, and you fail, and you learn nothing. Allow that which is most important to slip through your fumbling fingers like so many grains of sand, again and again and again, and you would remember us. You do forget yourselves. There is no common ground to be found between you and I. Nor do I require any. I have my duty.
Wait!
Well, we have confirmed the identity of our foe at least. And 'tis safe to say his objective is the rejoining.
But we still have no idea how playing the part of a warrior of light will further his cause, nor why he would spur others to do the same.
Another visit to the Tempest may shed some light upon these mysteries. Whether we are to exchange words or blows with Elidibus at our next meeting, the fact remains, we know too little. Ere our paths cross again, I would learn more of the world that once was, and of Elidibus himself. In this, we would be best served going directly to his home, much as Emmett Selk came to ours.
Though I see the wisdom in thy suggestion, the Amarot we visited is but a phantom born of Emmett Selk's memory. I fear it will teach us little that we do not already know.
I quite agree. Yet the ruins of the actual city remain unexplored. Given the vastness of the Tempest, I should not be surprised were there more such structures like to those in which the Ondo reside. A man after my own heart.
Assuming we are all in agreement, then I suggest we first pay a visit to the Ondo. If anyone can tell us where more ruins are to be found, it is them.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.